world do you think celebrity chefs have had on society in the last 15 years?
Well, it's a funny question, that because, you know, when Jamie Oliver started, you know, everyone bagged him, you know, he's this young guy, he didn't do any formal training, you know. But look at what he's done, look at what he's achieved.
Mm.
You know, yeah, he's built a huge empire being, you know, a celebrity chef, but look at what he's taught people, the average housewife. You know, he stood up for schools, you know, school diners, and he pushed for the best for the kids. So I think there's a lot of respect to go out there about teaching the public on what to eat and how to eat. Gordon Ramsay as well, you know, he's done a lot of that. Never mind F word and everything else, but you know, when they travel around the country and showing the different types of cuisines from India to France, I mean, I love Floyd's cooking program.
Floyd?
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, I thought he was an absolute legend. Rick Stein as well. So, you know, I think they have their place in the industry. And
do you think some chefs are well known for educating and sort of broadening the knowledge of the food available, or do you think chefs can actually teach how to become a Michelin star chef on the TV?
I think that's probably the problem with celebrity chefs, with the young ones we get through, is, you know, they've seen them on television and they come in the kitchen expecting it not to be so hard, you know.
Yes.
They see, you know, Gordon Ramsay on TV and think they can come in and be this hot chef. And sorry, you're going to start off in the back there peeling some potatoes first.
Yes.
Before you get to the hot stove. You know, yes, you will clean the floor before you start cooking. You know, they don't realize that it's such hard work, you know, after seeing it on television. They're suddenly in this dream world.
Yes.
But I think there's a lot of respect, you know, due to the celebrity chefs who have taught people how to eat, what to eat, what is what's acceptable, you know, and a lot to do with seasonal flavors, seasonal food that is coming through.
Yes.
I think, you know, Jamie Oliver, and it deserves a medal for that.
Yes, he does. Mm. He does. I think he's hit the domestic market superbly well. I think it's always more difficult to get a three-star chef demonstrating on TV and hoping that will be replicated, because it's impossible.
It's difficult, you know, it's very difficult. Even for myself to do a demonstration, you know, they say, or cooking something live, you know, and they say, can you give us a masterclass in 20 minutes? And they want, you know, a meat dish with a sauce and a garnish, you know, and everything else in 20 minutes.
That's
you
tough.
Are joking. Yeah. And then you want that poor person to go away and replicate it. It's not going to happen.
How much would you say a lot of what's on TV is entertainment rather than education? Is it like 50-50?
There's
what would
a
you
lot
say?
Of cooking programs out there for entertainment.
You've yes.
got Come Dine With Me.
Yes.
What is that all about?
I know.
You know, there are a lot of cooking programs out there.
Yes.
I mean, I fell into this one through Michelle.
Thank you.
MasterChef. And I don't know if I'd ever do another one, or if I did, it'd be something similar to what I do now.
Yes.
You know, it's, you find you're actually bringing through new talented chefs, and you're actually teaching them and explaining them as they progress through the competition.
Yes, that's important, isn't it? What do you, what's your view of the supermarkets at the moment, and the food that you buy there compared to the food that comes through your back door?
There's still a long way to go, I think, for supermarkets. But you know, 10 years ago. 12 years ago, when I first arrived here, there's been a huge change. I remember going into Marks and Spencer's or Sainsbury's, you know, and find a rack of lamb for a ridiculous price, and it wasn't even a very good quality.
Mm.
You know, as to now, you get great, you can buy veal in Waitrose, you know, so, but they are the top, aren't they? You know, Marks
yes.
and Spencer's, I think, and Waitrose, they're fantastic value. Sainsbury's are doing quite well as well. You know, there's still a way to go, you know, especially with the fish. They do have fish stands on the side and that, but even to the trained eye, you know whether it's fresh or not, yeah.
When you were growing up, did you eat a lot of fish being in the Pacific?
Yes, but you know, I was raised in New Zealand, you know,
right.
We do a lot of fishing. My father loves fishing, he has his own boat. It's part of our culture, you know, mussels, seafood, we absolutely love
it. Gosh, it just sounds totally idyllic where you've worked. If you're not up like coconut trees and stuff, you're out sort of fishing, which is absolutely amazing. If you were to walk into a college, and obviously colleges have just gone back, it's their first week What would you say to 16-year-olds who are just beginning their career?
What would you say to a 16-year-old? I would say the world is their oyster. They can accomplish anything they want. They put their heart and mind to it. You know, if it's their dream to do this, then you know, just go for it. No one has to know what that dream is. You know, they need to hold it in their fist and just go for it.
Okay, what do you think of colleges generally in the UK?
I don't have a lot to do with the colleges here, right, saying that, but you know, we have had a few through. What we do find with some of the students coming through is, they're lazy. No, they're not well prepared enough for the hours that they're going to do in this industry.
Okay.
You know, they need to be prepared for the hours, you know, the stamina that they need to work in a kitchen. It's hard. And they need to be warned. They will be shouted at some time of their career, you know. And a lot of them, you know, don't take being told what to do. You know, if you get five of them through, you're lucky if you get two stick it through a year in the kitchen. You know, it's more and more now we get parents calling up in places for the kids because they've woken up late or they're not coming in because they're tired or someone shouted at them or they've had to have a week off, you know, because they've come down with a cold. You know, they're not taking any responsibility more and more these days.
That is really disappointing.
It is disappointing, isn't it? Because I was taught, you know, if I was sick, I called in and told the boss, you know, that I was sick, you know. But it's more and more parents are doing it, you know, 17, 18-year-olds.
That's incredible. But I'm not surprised to hear that. But it's interesting to know that even at this level, you're not insulated from that.
No.
It just goes to show that it's right across
there. Yeah, it's all the way across.
And in terms of the skills that these guys who are leaving college, like, do you feel that the colleges are preparing the students with the right relevant skills? Have they seen a water bath before? Would they know what a backpacker should do? Are you finding that they have those skills?
Not really, but you know, it's all new still. This, you know, and I guess, you know, each kitchen has different equipment. They need to be shown how these equipment work. That's not a problem. I think it's more the basic skills, you know, wash the vegetable before you peel it.
Yes.
Things like, you know, the simplest skills, knife skills, you know, never mind putting something into water bath. You know, my four-year-old can do that. Or using a backpack machine. It's the basic skills they need to, you know, get right. But in saying that, you know, we've had, you know, even at the moment, we've got 17, 18-year-old boys who've just come from Scotland. And, you know, he's eaten on his days off. He goes and eats at a Michelin restaurant. He saves his pay to go and eat at a Michelin restaurant when he can. You know, he's always curious what's going on. He's always asking questions, though it's annoying sometimes. You know, but I think you're either born with it, and you know you really want to do this, so they go.
Yeah.
No, we're still here.
Yeah.
You know, and then some of them, you know, they've sort of just decided, you know, in college, oh well, you know, I'm going to do cooking and see how I go with that. Otherwise, you know, I'll just get mum and dad to give them a call and say no, I'll try something else.
That's not good enough, is it?
I sound too harsh, don't I?
No. You see, the thing, what a chef cooks is an extension of his personality, and so to have a team deliver that consistently, you need to have discipline. It needs to be regimented, if you don't, it'll then all hell's going to break loose to some degree. Just one or two quick questions. Where's your favourite restaurant in London, except where you work?
Except for where I work.
Where do you like to go out with the family?
Does it have to be in London?
No. Where's your favourite restaurant in the UK?
I love the Waterside.
Yes.
I absolutely love the Waterside in the summer.
Sure.
But then in saying that, there's this little Thai restaurant near us called Regional Thai.
Regional Thai. And where's that? Sutton, is
it? It's in Cheam Village.
Cheam Village. Region. Okay.
They make the best Thai green curry.
Everyone must go there. It's a good advert, this.
It's a little restaurant, and the lady that owns it, you know, all the recipes were her mom's, and I think she comes from a family of 12 or 13.
Okay.
And she has brothers and sisters in New York and throughout the world, and they've all got this Thai restaurant.
Okay.
Or regional Thai, and it's all her siblings, you know, who opened them.
Amazing.
That's a very cute restaurant. If
you okay, everyone's going to go. Everyone's going to mob flash it tonight. Do you get the chance to travel internationally? Are there any restaurants abroad that you like?
More so in France.
Okay.
In France, I would say my favourite restaurant there would be La Meloise.
Okay.
It's a 3 Michelin. Has been so for, I believe, a good 20-odd years, if not more.
That's some going, isn't it?
Yeah, and I love the food. It's fantastic. You know, it's based on classics, but it's got a more modern touch to it. But I love, you know, in France, when you go to a 3-2 Michelin restaurant in France, you know, the people that in the front of house, they work there 30 years, you know, that it's their life. They don't change jobs like they do here.
Yes.
Every couple of years, you know, and they're so relaxed.
It's
and
a different talk, world.
You know, it's completely relaxed. It's 3 Michelin, and, you know, next to you, you've got some people in jeans and a sweatshirt or a t-shirt, but they're having just as good a time as we are, not being treated any different at all.
Interesting.
Yeah.
That's really nice. It's,
I like that it's unpretentious, you know, you can have a lovely, lovely romantic time, or you could be on holiday in your jeans.
Yes,
you know, and know you're not going to be looked down on or look different because of what you're wearing.
Yes.
But that, for me, is my favourite restaurant, Lemon Wise.
Okay. How would you describe your own cooking style at the moment?
My own cooking style, I think it's always developing. It's so difficult. At the moment, you know, I'm working on a cookbook at the moment, and part of it, I'm doing a chapter in the book called Something Different, and I'm sort of drawing on what I've grown up with, the style of cooking I've grown up with, yet I've adapted them to suit, I've altered the way our food used to be, sort of using what I've learned throughout my career, and I find that really exciting.
Okay.
I think my dad would be really annoyed.
Okay.
Because I've taken his recipe of, for example, his octopus stew, and I've completely changed it, you know.
You made it edible now, is it?
I think I've made it more attractive to the European market.
That's interesting. Can you see a Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere, a different palate? Expectations?
Yes, it's completely different, and you know the types of food here to New Zealand anyway, I think are completely different. Australia, fantastic. I think they're much lighter on that side of the world than here.
Really?
Yes.
It's very interesting to hear.
Yeah. Personally, but yeah.
I don't know too many great restaurants in New Zealand. Is there a Michelin presence there?
No, there isn't.
No.
There isn't. I'm actually out of touch myself with the New Zealand restaurant scene.
Okay.
I have friends who cook there, but I couldn't name any restaurant that sort of stands out for me.
Maybe the audience can send in a postcard to our website about this, if there's any good restaurants in New Zealand. We mentioned the word Michelin quite a lot in our discussion. What is your view of the guides in general? Zagat, the Hardens, Michelin, the AA. Have you any... What's your view?
I think they have a lot of influence on the people's choice, excuse me, on dining out, isn't it?
You know,
if people want guidance on where to go, that's where they go. They open these books and they read these reviews. You know, it's always mixed. It's for myself, and I'm sure people out there who think, well, why have they got 3 Michelin? You know, they shouldn't have that. I've had a horrible experience there. But, you know, they help the business along, don't they? They have their place, and I think they are needed for that.
Yeah. You mentioned about 5 minutes ago you have a 4-year-old. How do you manage having a child and working the amazing hours that you do? It must be really difficult to juggle. Can you explain that?
It is really difficult, you know, but... what I do is something I love a lot.
Yes.
My daughter is the love of my life, you know, so it's finding the balance that
yes.
works. I think I'm fortunate that Michelle has let me do that. I can do 5 days a week here. And when I'm not here, my husband is. So when I'm not home, he is. That's the balance.
Right.
It's not easy.
Is your husband in the trade?
My husband's the head sommelier here.
Really?
Yes.
Fantastic.
So David, he's probably downstairs at the moment. It's not easy. It's like any working mom.